And just to let all you sports fans know that Match of the Day will return here in Trevor Sports. You can see that on Trevor TV 1 in the autumn with the return of FIFA 20. And now here on Trevor Sports, it's time for Test Match Cricket at Lord's. It's the Ashes with Trevor Match Special. Good morning to you. Welcome to Lord's here. It's always a special occasion when Australia are in town and the Ashes are on the stake and England are 1-0 up. Four tests still to go in this five test series as well, and the tension is building. Australia, real pressure on them for deliver as well. For England, some changes made. Let's go and take you through the teams. England still go with Rory Burns and Jason Roy opening up the batting order, but Johnny Bairstow has moved up to bat four. Joss Butler is taking the gloves and he's moving down to six as well. Sam Curran is brought in as well. Mark Wood, despite a lot of about his health, he's fit enough to play. James Vince, sadly due to an ankle injury, which we've seen struggling with in the end in his innings in the first test, does not play. No changes for Australia. They stick with the same side as well. Are the selectors showing great faith for their ability? Mitchell Starc passes a late fitness test as well. Questions of David Warner and Steve Smith and their fitness is to be there as well. And Cameron Bancroft has still not been selected as well. Well, Lord's is always a special occasion to play Test Match Cricket. The members have been queuing here long before the gates have opened. We've got a sellout potentially for the next 5 days if the test can go that long as well. But the weather doesn't look good as well. Rain predicted today, tomorrow and on day five as well. So it looks as if that this, if it goes this way and that way, may well be draw territory as well. However, this Lord's wicket, as we saw in the World Cup final as well, is difficult to bat on. There'll be swing this morning for the swing bowlers and there could well be turn later on as well, especially if you're bowling into the hill as well. There's always a chance of that odd ball keeping a little low and nicking back as well and getting out to the odd Jaffa. Let's go ahead and let's see who wins the toss and let's join Trevor Benner.
Well, it looks like it's going to be a bit of a miserable 3 or 4 days. Rain predicted as the English summer well and truly takes into effect. This meant winning the toss was vital. You really sensed here on Lord's on a day like today that there could be opportunities. Joe Root sensed it. He put Australia into bat and England won the toss. Tim Payne was sent in with his side. England sent their side out for the start of the second test at Lord's. Yep. And that is a fine stroke by David Warner. Right through extra cover. And that's Australia's first boundary. And you can look at that, he's got such a wonderful technique, Warner, as well. That position there to just hold his elbow high and strike through the ball. That's just proper batting, that. Yes. And Harris again turns. And it's very much through cover. Four signal there by Chris Gould. Just waits for it to come late. Maybe even just striping that right through point. Runs again. Full house here at Lord's, enjoying the day. It's always a special occasion when the Ashes arrives at Lord's. And that's a lovely hit through point again by Warner, who's looking like he's in imperious form here today. Despite all of Wood's pace, he's being dispatched. Four more. Yep. Warner looks to be in really good nick. That'll be runs. Oh, brilliant stuff by Mark Woods. 88.8 mile an hour, but look at that. Just darted slightly back off the swing. Reckon that was the in-swinger. Mark Woods got the breakthrough. Harris is out. He's bowled here. The last hour was just starting to be Australia's. England get back in the match. Yep. He's just such a classical player, Khawaja. And he just effortlessly make that look so easy. Lovely batting. And it's the area through point and cover where Australia have been dominant today. And Warner flicks that away. It's been a tough morning, but rain is coming down here, so the umpires have pulled Australia away. And sadly, 17 overs were lost. So we came back for an early lunch, and the afternoon session kicked off. Ooh, inside edge, I think. No, out! Ben Stokes strikes here. Warner doesn't appeal this. He's gone LBW. I thought there was inside edge. He's out for 27. It's 46 for 2. If you have a look at it from this angle here, it looks like there's inside edge, but look at the following angle here. It was pad first, just. Let's see what Hotspot says here. This will be the conclusive. Umpire gave it straight away. Warner elected not to review. And you can see there, the first effort is on the pads. Good umpiring. That's out. And just a matter that Warner was probably best not to review this. This is Hawkeye. He has him absolutely plumb. Great cricket from Stokes. Excellent delivery. Khawaja again, and that's exactly what he can do, and that's just what Australia need this afternoon. More of that, please. Lovely shot. Oh, Ben Stokes with that ball swinging in again. It's a full length. Big appeal, not out. Umpire's unmoved. Conference here, Root, Butler and Stokes. Do you review this? Yeah. Ben Stokes possibly feeling that his last attempt to get Khawaja. It wasn't reviewed and any response. With a lovely effort here. Through backwards square leg. Just slowed up a little bit where we've had a bit of rain here this morning. I mean, Annie couldn't get that. Yep. So good from Steve Smith. It is so good. Driving that to the cover point boundary quite comfortably. yet to really find the score in this series. Australia's batting has been pretty woeful at Edgbaston. Can it be any better today? And Steve Smith makes short work. Lovely cover drive. Sam Curran was very unlucky not to take more than two wickets at Edgbaston. We're hoping for a bit more here today. The Surrey man playing at Middlesex's grounds. Smith today is looking in an absolutely imperious form. He's got himself in and now he's starting to play his shots. Swivel the hips. He was in the air but there was no one square. Ball can't cut that off. Umpire Simon signals four. Yes. That's just brilliant again by Smith. Very classical flick of the wrists. He's able to take it right through mid-wicket. He looks rather imperious in his approach to his batting today, Steve Smith. Second test back to really make a meaningful impact in the defeat at Edgbaston. Crowds have stayed here. It's a sellout. 4 days at least, if we get that far. And that is out! And Mark Wood there, jumping in from extra cover, takes the catch. Jimmy Anderson with the wicket, top edge. Flew all the way to Mark Wood, ran forward to take the catch and take a comfortable 1-2. There's a big wicket. England needed that this afternoon. Australia being scoring runs quite freely. It's Steve Smith that's out for 28. It's 99 for 3. Yeah. Kawaja is still enjoying himself. He's got going here. 70 deliveries. Taking him to 37 now, not out. Through backwards square. Lovely little cut that. Very difficult to do. Great batting. Joe Root's got to encourage his guys here. He's put his team in and knows that you really want Australia out around about the 250 mark, I think. Yeah. Khawaja does that so well. Getting it to just flick off his pads and away. Can afford to hit it in the air around that mid-wicket region. There's no fielder there. That's easy runs. Well done. There's been the Khawaja so at the moment. Trevor's head hasn't seen anything and he won't see any more action. Thick edge and out. Stuart Broad comes on. Well, he was so instrumental in taking England to their victory at Edgbaston. That's what it always does. The one that moves away. Left-handers really struggle to that. And Butler takes a firm catch. Trevor says he's out for three. It's 114 for four now. He's two away from his half century. He's on Khawaja. Played really, really well. And he's been bowled by Jimmy Anderson with a fantastic in-swinger. And he's absolutely annoyed with himself, Khawaja, because there was a score to be made here today. He's just not picked up the way that ball has swung. He's been looking there to knock it away. He's gone for 48. It's 124 for 5 now, Australia. Oh! Back foot there. Umpire Gould is unmoved. Do England review this? Yes, they do. They fancy this. I think this is probably going past off. Swung a lot here by Woods. Legal delivery first and foremost. And if you have a look just how far Hanscom comes over his stumps. But he misses that. That is a pretty bad review. because that's going down off wide by a long way. That's a review wasted by England. Hanscom survives. Sam Curran to the Australian captain. Oh, just short of Moeen Ali at Gully. Tim Payne there with the edge. He's got soft hands and Kookaburra back there. The ball just didn't carry. Look at this by Sam Curran. Ball hits the decks. It's the cutter. There is a edge. Would have gone just a fourth slip if England had had it. They haven't. They've got Gully. Moeen Ali sadly picks up a dot ball in the end. Yep. Tim Payne goes after Sam Curran. 85 miles an hour. Turns and strikes it through cover. Runs. Yes. Oh, brilliantly again done by Tim Payne. Brilliantly stuff. Australia's run rate is just under 3 and over at the moment. And they've had to battle, and they've had to dig in. Well, when England have gone too close to the pads, they've put them away. Too wide, they've dispatched it. It's been sensible batting in these conditions at Lord's. Oh, now! Sam Curran can cope with much more of this. Umpire Simon says no. England have decided not to appeal. And that might be why. Impact going past and missing the stumps. So traffic light review that. But England have decided not to take it. Yes. Tim Payne doing so well. Just a able to go onto the back foot and knock Sam Curran for another boundary here. The Australian captain looking in good touch here. An opportunity to go on the honours board. And Sam Curran gets a bit of treatment here. Yep. Tim Payne, my words. Turns and strikes that through deep backward points, through the slips, along the ground. That is absolutely audacious. And Sam Curran is getting some treatment here. Brought in for what he did against India. Oh, excellent stuff by Tim Payne. Threw down to deep mid-wicket. In the air and away. Runs. Oh, a thick edge, and Peter Hanscom's going to get one. That's gone through backward point for four. And Stokes looks frustrated. England bowling here. The sun's come out. Lords has looked a much more friendlier decision. Maybe they should have batted first. Yes. Well, there's lots going on there. Stuart Broad and not out. Fantastic batting. Wonderful straight drive. And that will be a half century for the Australian captain, who has led a real recovery here. 50 off 86 minutes. Well played. And he's been not afraid to play anywhere along the ground. Been great batting. There is a score here for the Australian captain. Yes, yes. Oh, Peter Hanscom, that is brilliant. Right back over the bowler's head, and it's rolled down the hill for four. Bairstow can't reach that. Fantastic off drive, not afraid to hit it right over mid-off. Brilliant stuff. That might be the shot of the day. And a lovely classic cover drive by the Australian captain takes him to 62. And Australia are getting away from England here in this evening session. Oh, that is huge. That is huge. Mark Woods out. Yes. Well, that is massive in the contest. Mark Woods got Tim Payne here. Thick outside edge. Good catch. First time Tim Payne has mistimed anything today. Root jumping up and appealing. He's out for 62. Tim Payne, Australia, 213 for 6. Big, big moment. Oh, it's not out. It's not out. How do England challenge this? One remaining. Got to, surely. Yes, they are. Yes, they are. This is going to be so close. This is going on to take out leg stump. Get Pat Cummins here. Get Australia. Really rocking here because he's got the ability here to play a few shots. Mark Wood with the one that swings back in. No bat involved here, but is this moving too much? You can see there where it swings in. So if you're playing it straight, that's a perfect little straight drive. It swings back in. Does it swing too much, though? Is it going to miss leg? So the original decision is not out. Pitch is in line. Impact is in line, but you can see there it's swinging and missing leg stump. That's another review lost for England. Pat Cummins has survived. And that is a wonderful day's cricket. The batting, though, led by Peter Hanscom, 34 not out. Tim Payne, 62, really well played as well. Khawaja deserved a half century for 48. England at times were a little bit lackadaisical and their field setting was far too attacking on Australia could score against him incredibly easy. 213 for 6. We've lost just about 2 hours today thanks to rain. The weather could play an effect tomorrow. Join us to find out what happens on day 2 of the Ashes.